Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to insert these two images into a document, one on top of the other, and then how to slightly manipulate it so you get this end result. So I've just opened a plain A4 document, and I'm not going to go up to File and then Open, because if I do that, when I open the image, it's going to open it in a new document. So you'll end up with another tab over here. And I want my images to actually be imported straight into my document. So for that, I'm actually just going to go to my Finder and I'm going to go and find my file. So my file is in my Downloads. So I'm going to go to Downloads and bring that up. When you just bring up your files, you can literally drag and drop them straight into Photoshop. So I'm going to get my first image here, drag it and drop it in. There we go. I'm just going to resize that slightly. And then once I'm happy, I just check that tick at the top and then do exactly the same. Go to Finder, go to Downloads, and then grab my second image, drag and simply drop it into my document. So there we have two images in the same document. Now, if you want to learn how to cut these out and put them on the tree, I'll just quickly take you through that. Thankfully, we've got a grey background here, so we can isolate these images just by taking out this gray background. So make sure you're on the layer, go to selection and go down to color range, and then just click roughly on the gray. You'll know you've got the gray because the picture will turn out like this. So make sure you've got the gray, and then here we've got color range. Just take that fuzziness up to about 26, because then the gray will then completely disappear. You won't have some little gray outlines around each icon. And then click OK. Now, once you've done that, we need to erase all of this. We can put a layer mask over it, but then when we come to copy and paste these little images to put them on their own separate layer to move them around, you will get this background back again. So we need to go up to our eraser tool. So you can either press E on your keyboard or click on the eraser tool here. Now, if it doesn't work, it's because your image is a smart object. And you can tell that because it will be inserted with this little icon in the layer. Now you have to rasterize this image in order for this to work, which is fine. All you do is click anywhere in this gray area in the layer and go down to rasterize layer. That will now mean that this is no longer a smart object. So whatever you do to this layer could be destructive and you can't necessarily go back. So once I erase this background and then do something else to it, it's quite destructive. So that's why we can use layer mask if you want to, but I don't want this background, so I know I'm not going to want it back. So get my eraser tool. I'm just going to increase the size of it. You can do that by going up to this icon here, clicking on the drop down, and then just moving this slider. And then I'm simply going to erase the gray background. Once I've done that, go to select, and go to deselect, and then we'll get rid of those little running ants or the dotted line. And now if we go to our move tool and make sure we're on this layer, if we move these around, oh, we've got a bit of gray there, we need to get rid of that. So let's just go back to the eraser tool, take that out. You can see that we move all the icons, we just want to move them separately. So in order to do that, we're just going to select them and copy and paste them. So make sure you're on this layer, go up to this rectangular marquee tool here, then just literally click and drag around an icon and then press Command or Control and J on your keyboard. And now with your move tool, go back up to move or press the V key on your keyboard. Now you've got a separate icon. And as you can see, it's now on a separate layer. In order to do that again, you've got to go back and click on the layer with all of the icons because it's copying from that layer. Go back up to your marquee tool and do exactly the same with the next one. Command and Control J. Now, I don't have to move them. I know I've seen them on the layer here, so I'm not necessarily going to go back to my move tool and keep moving them. I'm just going to keep copy and pasting them. So go back to my original layer, click and drag, Command and Control J, back to the layer, exactly the same, Command and Control J. So I'm going to do that for all the icons and speed up the video and come back and show you how you can easily select them and move them rather than trying to find them in the layers panel. Okay, so now we've finished. If I switch off this layer here with all the original icons, they will disappear, and now I can move these. But if you look over on the right-hand side at the layers, we've got all of these layers. And because those icons are so tiny, I'd have to go through each one, click on it, go to my Move tool, and then see which one moves. However, if you've selected your Move tool, if you hold down your Command or Control key and just click on any of the icons, it will select the correct layer and you'll be able to move that icon. So hold down the Command or Control key, click, and then you can move it. So you don't have to go backwards and forwards to the Layers panel to keep trying to find the one that you want. In addition, once you've found the icon you want to use, you can then press Command or Control T for your Transform tool. You can then resize it. If you want to keep the dimensions, hold down the Shift key. And you can rotate them as well. So particularly for this tree design, you might want to actually make them a bit smaller, rotate them so they look like they're hanging from the tree. Then just click OK at the top, Command or Control to select the next icon, Command or Control T to transform, and then you can go around and move all the icons to where you want them. So once again, I'm going to speed up the video until I've finished, and then I'll show you how to export it. Okay, so once you're finished, you've got all of these layers here. You simply need to go to File, then you can Save As, Save a Copy, or you can Export. Export as a JPEG, or Export As, and it will give you a number of different options. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.